You all remember like yesterday I say the daily case count seems to be like a roller coaster ride. And today I must say it is really like a roller coaster ride because yesterday it went up. But today it go down again eh. Ayo. But note okay, this down is because it's a weekend also lah. So weekend numbers usually tend to be on the lower side lah. And while we are happy lah, okay, maybe for a second or two on the lower community cases one thing to take note is that our imported cases is going up leh. I hope lah, okay, our Jing Hu is able to understand the fact that once the imported cases increases till certain threshold it's just a matter of time only, you know, before the community cases will also start to increase again lah. As of 21st November, 12 PM, MOH declared a total of 1,670 new cases in Singapore. This is a drop of 261 cases compared to previous day. Then there are also 1,577 community cases, 80 dormitory cases, and 13 imported cases. The weekly infection growth rate is currently at 0.81. As mentioned, it is really a roller coaster ride. One day go up, the next day can come back down again. But I must say, okay, today, especially today, the imported cases are indeed heading northwards. And then this one really need to be monitored closely. Once not careful only, if we still continue to allow this number to grow, I can tell you, confirm plus top one, community cases will rise again. Currently, there are 1,362 cases warded in the hospital, of which 186 of them actually require oxygen and 104 are in the ICU. Of the 104 in the ICU, 60 of them are critically ill and 44 are under close monitoring. The percentage of free ICU bed, this time around increased by 3.9 percentage point to actually 47.5%. This is a good news. Okay, it seems that our ICU capacity now quite okay already. We got quite a big buffer lah, 47.5, almost 50% buffer already. So this is good. This is good. It means that our healthcare workers can also have more a little bit more breathing space. I would say lah. Not so stressed like last time already. But then we cannot be complacent because you never know when the next wave will come on. You know. Now, let's take a quick look at the ICU bed utilization graph. Okay, there's a very good increase in the free ICU bed numbers. Okay, and I think this one is largely contributed by the non-COVID cases. Because there's a huge drop, you know. But then, something very strange, or I also want to ask is because it is the huge drop. Because you remember yesterday I said that there's a huge increase in the non-COVID cases for the ICU beds. Then today, huge drop again. So two possibilities I can think of. One is a mistake. Okay, yesterday they make a mistake, so today they normalize the mistake. Or two, really, it's a real case. A lot of people yesterday go into ICU for non-COVID cases. Then today, also a lot of people are discharged from ICU for the non-COVID cases. So between the two, I kind of think the mistake one higher chance. I don't know. What do you all think? What do you all think? Drop your comment below to let me know lah. Okay, today KO cases is in the single digit I will not say it's good or bad but you all must know every time as long as there's a KO case it means that someone somewhere out there has just lost a loved one Okay, so today we have a total 8 KO cases. Month to date for November we have 255 KO cases. And so far for November alone, it accounted for 38.5% of all the KO cases already. Okay, now come to summarize today report. Okay, we have a total of 252,188 infected cases. And for KO cases, we have a total of 662 KO cases in total. So that's it for today COVID update. Okay. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please do so, okay, and hit the bell button next to it, okay? Until my next video, please stay safe, and this is Kriscell signing off.